Bonjour, everyone. Welcome to another episode of Bible Q&A. Today we're discussing, is Jesus God's only son? The answer is no. In Job chapter 1, God Almighty called all his sons for an assembly. As it was said in Job chapter 1 verse 6, now there was a day when the sons of God came to present themselves before the Lord. And Satan came also among them. That's right. Even Satan is a son of God, according to Ezekiel chapter 28, verses 1 to 19. And it makes sense. He makes some mistakes, like making man fall in Genesis chapter 3, verses 1 to 6, and killing one of God's other sons, Jesus Christ, in Matthew chapter 27. But who cares? He's still God's child, right? What this tells us is that any angel can be considered a son of God. And when some angels decided to rebel against God and go down to meet some cute girls, they were called sons of God, as it was said in Genesis. And it came to pass, when men began to multiply on the face of the earth, and daughters were born unto them, that the sons of God saw the daughters of men that they were fair, and they took them wives of all which they chose. We can also look at 1 Peter chapter 3, verses 19 to 20. Angels were called sons of God because God created them, like everything else in the universe. Genesis chapter 1. Just like a parent has a hand in bringing someone into the world, God was responsible for giving the angels life. So they are his sons. Of course, this use of the word son has one major flaw. The term refers to all sorts of different people who have different values and beliefs. This is especially bad for Jesus, because A, he gets called the same thing as Satan, even though they are two completely different people, and B, Jesus' role as the creator of everything, along with God, is ignored. You see, God created Jesus directly, according to John chapter 5, verse 26. He was the first thing ever made. Everything else was just created through Jesus Christ. As it was said here, for by him were all things created, that are in heaven and that are in earth, visible and invisible, whether they be thrones or dominions or principalities or powers. All things were created by him and for him. And he is before all things, and by him all things consist. Colossians chapter 1, verses 16 to 17. We can also look at Ephesians chapter 3, verse 9. Therefore, the term son was modified a little when talking about Christ to reflect his special status among creation. He was a good boy, a really good boy, and he needed a good boy term. So he was called the only begotten son. Now that's a special title. He was the only person who came directly from God. This phrase would be used in one of the Bible's most famous verses. For God so loved the world, that he gave his only begotten Son, that whosoever believeth in him should not perish, but have everlasting life. John chapter 3, verse 16. And that is where I'm going to stop with this Bible Q&A. Is Jesus God's only son? No, God has many sons. But Jesus Christ is a special son to God. Thank you for listening. Don't forget to like and subscribe.